Stefan's piece, take one. Well, you've seen Robert Parker, and he told you how he turned a scratchy old record into a thing of beauty. I'm going to talk about how I took reality, if you can call Mardi Gras street scenes reality. It's not reality, is it? We're kidding ourselves. And turned it into, well, not a thing of beauty, but something that vaguely works with Dipper Mouth Blues, which was the point of the exercise. Not that I knew I was going to use it for Dipper Mouth Blues when I filmed it. I mean, I was just wandering around praying that I would find something useful that I could use in this program. And I was wandering around with this camera. This camera is a Sony. It's called a PDP-150, and it's about $3,500. And it's brilliant. It's got a flip-out screen here, which isn't that much use if you're filming outside in daytime because you can't really see. At nighttime, it's good. You can hold the camera up high and glance in here and see what you're filming. It's got another viewfinder besides the flip-out screen, and it's this one here. And you'd think I'm going to say this is the one I use, but in fact, I hardly use that either. What I do is I hold the camera like this, and I use my eyes to see what's happening. Because the whole idea when you're doing this is to see what's happening, and things may be happening over here while you're shooting over here. So what I do is I try to keep the camera steady, try to keep my elbows into my chest, and I glance down at the scene from time to time. And then if I see something happening over here, I swing the camera, and that way I don't miss it. And so I've got my eyes open, and I'm looking at the viewfinder. The same way as if you're driving a car, you kind of look in the rear vision mirror from time to time. That's what I'm doing. I'm glancing down here. The reason it works, well, the reason I think it works, you may look at my work and think, hey, this guy doesn't know what he's doing, is I'm using a wide-angle lens. And if I know that if I point the camera like that, it's going to get in most of the detail. Now, I have to be honest, I'm not using a wide-angle lens at all. I'm using an anamorphic lens, which has the same effect of a wide-angle. What have we got here? We've got a polarizing filter. This makes the sky look pretty and also turns down the exposure. You can't really use these cameras at f16 because they start photographing the muck that's on the lens. And I'm going to run you a bit from my tape, or my unedited tape, and you'll see muck on this lens. This is the anamorphic lens, which screws on. It's an extra. That is, you don't buy it with a camera. So looking through the anamorphic lens, this is what the shot really looks like. You can see everything squashed and people are kind of taller and thinner than they should be. But when you play it back on your DVD, the receiver knows that it's anamorphic and it unsquashes it and pulls it apart and it looks normal. This gives you a far better quality widescreen than if you actually just lopped off the top and lopped off the bottom. Then the other thing I carry is not a tripod, but I carry a monopod. And I normally carry a monopod not to get steady shots, but to get high shots. And I screw the monopod into the base here. And I don't use, you can use a quick release thing, and you'd kill somebody if you did because the camera would fall off. And I screw this right into the camera, and then I open this up so it's long and tall, and then this goes up very, very high, way, way higher than the ceiling in this room, and I get nice shots looking down on people. It is a dangerous thing to do. If you're pushed, you trip, you fall, this will land on somebody's head, and I'll be sued. But so far it hasn't happened. And because I can't see through the viewfinder, and in this case you actually do need to know what's going on because it's hard to guess what's happening up there, I run a wire from this camera to this little baby. This is another Sony camera, and it's called a PC-100, and I use it for filming the family and the kids and holidays and things. And I also take it as a backup camera if something goes wrong. In this case, what I do when I'm doing these high shots is I have this little camera down the bottom, have a wire from the top camera to this one, and I'm looking through this camera to see what this camera's filming. And it's tricky. Now I'm using the zoom control, which is unusual, because normally I work on a wide angle. But you can see once I've zoomed, all the flares that you were getting on the wide shot and the dirt on the lens, they've vanished. It's only when you're using the wide angle shot that you get this muck on the lens effect. was an easy sequence to edit. I chose the King Oliver solo at the end of Dipper Mouth Blues, put that down, and then looked for shots to fit. And I think I finished the entire edit in less than an hour. And it worked out that I only used 5 shots. And they just seemed to drop in. I didn't have to fiddle with them much to get them to look as though they were dancing to the King Oliver music. And that's a rarity. Usually editing is tough. This one was easy.